Hello and welcome students. Today myself Piraj Malinder welcomes you to MechPro channel, my official YouTube channel. And we are continuing our manufacturing processes. And we have already completed the module 1 and moved to module 2. And in the previous class, I have completed the sheet metal forming operations. Okay. Now we will move on to the different bulk metal forming processes, namely as extrusion, forging, rolling, etc. Okay. So let us start today's class. So today let us start with the extrusion process. Now extrusion, you can see over here, these are the extruded products. Now extrusion is another operation of bulk metal forming operations, and extrusion is the process of confining the metal in a closed cavity and then allowing it to flow from only one opening so that the metal will take the shape of the particular opening or orifice, whatever you say. Okay. Now this particular operation you can relate with the or you can say that it is more identical to the squeezing of toothpaste that you used to brush every day with the help of the toothpaste. The toothpaste from that toothpaste tube is coming out from an opening. So you can correlate that particular phenomena with this particular extrusion process. Okay. So this extrusion process is identical to the squeezing of toothpaste out of the toothpaste tube. Okay. Now what happens here? Metal is compressed and forced to flow through a suitably shaped die to form a product with reduced but constant cross section. Metal will undergo triaxial compression. So it is important to take a note, this one, triaxial compression. Okay, here in extrusion metal have to go under triaxial compression. Okay. Now generally hot extrusion is generally employed. Okay. Now the common metals are lead, copper, aluminium, magnesium, and alloys of these metals are commonly extruded. So these are also very important. Okay. Next. So here you can see the basic principle or setup of a extrusion process. Okay. So here you can see this is the cylindrical, looks like a IC engine cylinder. Here is the plunger. You can correlate it with a piston. Okay. This one is the, you can correlate with the piston. Okay. Now this one, so here two thing is there. One is your this one, this is the same material you can say, and this one is the dummy block. So these two are different thing, and here you will find the hot metal here. Hot metal will be here. Okay. Next, the hot metal will be coming out through this opening. Okay. So it will take the shape of this orifice or opening, you can say. Okay. Now this will be the extruded metal. Okay. So you can see over here, this one is the hot metal billet, and this is the plunger, and this is the cylinder, you can see over here, and this is the die. Okay. So in short, this is the setup of typical extrusion process. Now the equipment here consists of a cylinder container into which the heated metal billet is loaded. On one end of the container, the die plate with the necessary opening is fixed, and from the other end a plunger or ram, this one, compresses the metal billet against the container walls and the die plate, this one. From the other end, a plunger or ram compresses the metal billet against the container walls and the die plate, thus forcing it to flow through the die opening, acquiring the shape of the particular opening. Okay. So the extruded metal is carried by the metal handling system as it comes out of the die. Okay. So a dummy block, which is this one, is the dummy block. Here you can see this one will be the dummy block. It is generally made up of steel disc of about 40 millimeter generally, or you can say 0.5 to 0.75 of diameter thick, and with a diameter slightly less than the container is kept, this container, okay, between the hot billet and the plunger or ram to protect it from the direct heat. So direct heating will, you know, may hamper or damage this particular ram. So direct heating is prohibited, prohibited by the use of this particular dummy block that is made up of steel. Okay, now by the extrusion process, it is possible to make components which have a constant cross section over any length, and that can be handled by rolling process also. So you will be having a rolling class next. So there you will be having some knowledge on rolling process as well. And the complexity of the parts that can be obtained by extrusion is more than that of rolling, because the die required being very simple and easier to make also. Okay. Now also, extrusion is a single pass process, unlike rolling. Rolling can be multiple pass also. Okay. Now the amount of reduction that is possible in extrusion, you can see over here the amount of reduction that is possible in this particular extrusion is more than that of rolling, and that because the die required is, as I already earlier told you, that is very simple, this die. Okay, and also the amount of reduction that is possible in extrusion is very large in comparison to single pass rolling operation. Okay, so generally brittle materials can also be easily extruded in this particular extrusion process. Okay, now it is possible to produce sharp corners and re-entrant angles. Okay, now it is also possible to get shapes with internal cavities in extrusion by the use of spider dies. That is a special type of dies, and large diameter and thin walled tubular products with excellent eccentricity and tolerance characteristics can also be produced by the help of this extrusion process. Okay, now let us have some classification of the particular extrusion process. Here you can see there are hot extrusion as well as cold extrusion process. In the hot extrusion process, there is direct and indirect extrusion process. In cold comes the forward, backward, and under forward it is hydrostatic, and under backward it is cold extrusion forging and impact extrusion for operation also. Okay, now look this one. Steels, stainless steels and nickel based alloys are very difficult to extrude. Okay, as because of their high yield strengths welding with wall. Okay, so it gets stick with the wall, the hot metal. Okay, so we have to use lubricants like phosphate based and molten glass. Okay, next, this picture gives you the different type of extruded shapes or metals coming out of the extrusion. Okay, so here you can see, have an idea of the different shapes of the metals being produced by the help of the extrusion process. Okay, now hot extrusion process. What is hot extrusion process? Look, the temperature range for hot extrusion of aluminium, particularly aluminium, as because aluminium is widely used for extrusion process, is around 430 to 480 degrees Celsius. Now it is used to produce curtain rods made of aluminium. Okay, now design of die is a problem, and either direct or indirect method can be used in hot extrusion process. Now coming to the cold extrusion process, it is used with low strength metals such as lead, tin, zinc, aluminium to produce collapsible tubes for toothpaste, medications and other creams. Now small cans for shielding electronic components and larger can for food and beverages are also produced out of this cold extrusion process, and nowadays also been used for forming mild steel parts as well. Now coming to the direct extrusion process. Okay, so a solid ram drives the entire billet to and through a stationary die. You can see over here, this is a stationary die, this is the billet where the hot metal is being placed, and this is the ram, as I earlier told you, and the opening is there, and the opening, from the opening, due to the pressure of the ram, it is being pushed, the hot metal is being pushed to move out of this opening, and it will take the shape of the opening as well. So this is how extrusion process is done generally. Okay, so what it says, its solid ram drives the entire blade to and through a stationary die and must provide additional power to overcome the frictional resistance between the surface of the moving blade, this one, and the confining chamber, this one. This is the confining chamber. Okay, so this is the container, you can see over here, this is the container and this is the die, this one is the die and this is the opening. Okay, so this is the direct extrusion process. Now indirect extrusion process, what happens in indirect extrusion process, a hollow ram drives the die back through a stationary confined blade. So this is a hollow ram. So look, in the previous one what happens, the ram moves along with the, you know, this along the direction of the moving of the particular hot metal. But in the indirect extrusion what happens, the ram moves in this direction while the metal moves opposite to the direction of the ram. So this is the indirect, you must keep in mind and you must not get confused in your examination. Okay, so hollow ram drives the die back through a stationary confined billet. Since no relative motion, friction between the billet and the chamber is eliminated. Okay, so this is the difference between direct extrusion and indirect extrusion. Okay, now backward cold extrusion, the metal is extruded through the gap between the punch and die opposite to the punch movement. For softer materials such as aluminiums and its alloys, it is being carried out, the backward cold extrusion, and it is also used for making collapsible tips, cans for liquids and similar articles. Okay, so here is the backward extrusion. You can see over here, this is a cylinder, this is a hot metal billet, and this is the extruded metal coming out of this opening, and this is the plunger, you can see over here, and this one is the ram, this one. So here you can see, this is the confined region or cylinder as well, and this one is your die. Okay, and this is the hot molten metal coming out of this chamber from this opening, particular opening. Okay, so this is all about backward extrusion. Next is our impact extrusion. Okay, so impact extrusion, here is the diagram of impact extrusion, you can see over here. So this is the diagram of the impact extrusion, and the backward cold extrusion is much more common, particularly with softer materials such as aluminium and its alloys. So you can take a note that aluminium are being widely used as extruded materials for extrusion process mainly. Okay, so in what happens in backward cold extrusion, also called as the impact extrusion, the setup consists of a die and a punch. As you can see over here, this is the die and this is the punch. Okay, now what happens, the slug for making the component is kept on the die, this is the slug, and the punch strikes the slug against the die. So you can see over here, ultimately it becoming this type of shape. Okay, now the metal is then extruded through the gap, okay, between the punch and the die opposite to the punch movement. So punch is coming downwards and the metal is moving upward, you can see over here in this particular picture. Because of the impact force, the side walls go straight along the punch, though they are not confined. The height of the sidewalls is controlled by the amount of the metal in the slug, this one. So this is the slug. Okay, now this one is the slug and this is the metal. Okay, so this process are more commonly used for making collapsible tubes, for housing pastes, liquids and for similar articles. Okay, now coming to the hydrostatic extrusion, another classification of extrusion process. So in hydrostatic extrusion what happens, it is being another type of cold extrusion process, you can also say, and it is a special application, it is a special application in extrusion process mainly. Okay, so in this particular operation what happens, the metal billet is compressed from all sides by a liquid rather than the ram. So you can have a look on this particular picture. Okay, so here you can see, this is the ram and this is the being actually the total is, you can say, the RAM, or you can say this is the plunger as well. Now a force is being applied on this particular plunger, and this is the liquid fluid portion, you can say also, okay. And this one is the extruded part, this one, okay. Now this is the container, and these are the dies, these two are the dies, okay. Now this is the working blade, this is the working blade, okay. Now what happens over here, presence of liquid inside the container eliminates the need for any lubricant. Also, the material is more uniformly compressed from all sides throughout the deformation zone, okay. Now for because of this, what happens, highly brittle materials such as gray cast iron can also be extruded. Now some of the pressure transmitting fluids used here are generally castor oil, SAE 30 mineral lubricating oil, glycerin, ethyl glycol, isopentane, etc. Okay, now hydrostatic pressure range is, you can take a note, generally it is around, for hydrostatic pressure range it is around, you know, 1110 to 3150 MPa, okay. So that is the range for hydrostatic extrusion, okay, 1110 to 3150 MPa, okay. Now the commercial application of this particular process are limited to the extrusion of the this reactor or fuel rods in atomic power stations, okay. So cladding of metals, making wares of less ductile materials likewise, okay. Now let us have some more knowledge. So it says high pressure fluid applies the force to the workpiece through a die. It is a forward extrusion process. As you can see, the direction of the movement of the plunger or ram, whatever you say, is in the same direction with the flow of the molten metal as well from the opening, okay. So this is a forward extrusion, but the fluid pressure surrounding the billet prevents upsetting, okay. Now billet chamber friction is eliminated, as because we are using fluid and which is acting as a lubricant, so friction is somewhat eliminated, and the pressurized fluid acts as a lubricant between the billet and the die. Now temperature is limited since the fluid acts as a heat sink, it can take the extra heat, and the common fluids like light hydrocarbons and oils burn or decomposes at moderately low temperatures, okay. Now the metal deformation is performed in a high compressive environment, so crack formation is suppressed, leading to a phenomenon known as pressure induced ductility. Now relatively brittle materials like cast iron, stainless steel, molybdenum, tungsten, and various intermetallic compounds can be plastically deformed without fracture, and materials with limited ductility become highly plastic. Next, I already mentioned you the application portion of the hydrostatic extrusion as well. Once again, it is the extrusion of nuclear reactor fuel rod, cladding of metals, making wares for less ductile materials. Now extrusion ratio is very important, you must take a note, this is going to be a objective questions. So extrusion ratio is the ratio of the cross sectional area of the billet to the cross sectional area of the product as well. So it is a cross section area of the billet to the cross sectional area of the product, that is the extrusion ratio, how much it was before and to the how much it became after being extruded, that is the ratio, and it is known as extrusion ratio. About 40:1 for hot extrusion of metal, so you can actually steel, so you can see from here, or you can have a conclusion from this particular extrusion ratio, that it is a huge reduction, 40:1, okay. Now for aluminium it is going to be much higher than 10 times than that of steel, so it is coming to be 400:1, that is the extrusion ratio for aluminium, okay. So these are very important, you must take a note. Next we have, we have some extrusion pressures for different materials. So you can take a note or have a screenshot over here. So particularly you can see over here, soft lead, it is coming to be 275 to 420 MPa pressure. For copper bearing loads, it is coming to be 300 to 500 MPa. For tin, it is 420 to 620, and tin base alloys, it is 275 to 700. Soft copper alloys, it is about 200. And you can see over here, hard copper, it is up to 850. For silicon bronze, it is 950. For aluminum, it is 70 to 700. For magnesium, it is 35 to 350. And for zinc base alloys, it is coming to be 700 to 850. So you can see over here, silicon bronze has the highest one among these materials. And we have the 35 to 350 and 275 to 420. So lead and magnesium are having the least extrusion pressures. Now coming to the cold extrusion pressure, these are the generally hot extrusion pressures. Now coming to the cold extrusion pressure, you can see over here, aluminium is having 600 to 1100 MPa pressure, whereas brass having 450 to 800, copper having 400 to 1100. C10 steel having 800 to 2500. So steel are having, you know, you can see from here, having larger amount of extrusion pressure, whereas brass is comparatively low pressure, having low extrusion pressure, as well as aluminium also 600 to 1100. So these are the, you know, typical pressure ranges for different materials in hot extrusion as well as cold extrusion process. Okay, now coming to the lubrication portion for extrusion. For hot extrusion, glass is an excellent lubricant with steels, stainless steels, high temperature metals and alloys. And for cold extrusion, lubrication is critical, especially with steels, because of the possibility of sticking scissor between the workpiece and the tooling if the lubrication breaks down. So most effective lubricant is phosphate conversion coating on the workpiece. Now coming to the advantage of extrusion. Any cross-sectional shape, that is the most important, you must take a note that any cross-sectional shape can be extruded from the non-ferrous metals. Okay, now many shapes, now in rolling you are having some limitations over different shapes. So extrusion process, you can see in case of giving desired shape, any desired shape, extrusion process is the versatile one. Okay, now no draft is required, as because there is no possibility of reviewing the metal, so no draft is required. Now huge reduction, as I earlier mentioned you, in case of steel that was 40:1, and in case of aluminium it was around 10 times that of the steel, that is 400:1. So we are getting huge reduction in cross section in comparison to other bulk metal forming process such as rolling, etc. Okay, now conversion from one product to another requires only a single die change, that is also very profitable. Now good dimensional precision is also possible out of this particular extrusion process. So you can see extrusion process is one of the versatile process in bulk metal forming process as well. Okay, now limitation is cross section must be uniform for the entire length of the product, that is the limitation of the extrusion. Now coming to the extrusion defects, look, surface crack due to high temperature, high speed, high friction, etc. So there may be a development of crack in the surface of the extruded product. Bamboo defects, look, you must note, have a, you know, this bamboo defect is important for your MCQ purposes. So bamboo defects is related to this particular extrusion process. They may be asking questions, bamboo defects is related to whether extrusion, rolling, forging or any other. So you have to mark extrusion process. So bamboo defect at low temperature due to sticking of metals in die line, this particular bamboo defect is related to extrusion process. Next is your pipe defects or tailpipe or fistelling. This is also very important. They may be asking you MCQs on particular this defect, and they will be providing you four options, and you have to tick mark on the extrusion process. So pipe defect or tailpipe or fistelling is particular defect arising out of the extrusion process, you must keep in mind. So it is happened during the extrusion surface oxides, and impurities are driven towards the center of die like funnel called pipe. So that is the
pipe defect. Next is your center burst or chevron defect. It is attributed to a state of hydrostatic tensile stress at the center line in the deformation zone in the die. So tendency increases with increasing die angle and amount of impurities as well. Now tendency decreases with the increasing extrusion ratio and friction. Now application, I already mentioned there are various applications, as because this particular extrusion process is a very versatile process in bulk metal forming process. Now working of poorly plastic and non-ferrous metals and alloys, you can easily apply extrusion process. Now manufacture of section and pipes of complex configuration, so I have already mentioned you that any desired shape can be extruded out of this extrusion process. Okay, now medium and small batch production, you can also apply extrusion process. Manufacturing of parts of high dimensional accuracy as well as precision also. So you can see there are various application of the extrusion process. Now I think you have learned a lot about the extrusion process. I hope you have enjoyed the class today. Thank you for watching.